And then we're going to open this box and try to look for the report inside.
Inside the money.
Yeah.
So you want to... So yeah. So what are you finding here?
Richard, you got it.
Oh, and yeah, we found the report. The research. See, amidst all the money that has been laundered, amidst all the money that has been laundered, that has been stolen, we have people that are still doing work in trying to find the culprits and actually get the offenders to account for all the missing billions. So, this is the report. You will now get a copy.
It's not Cynthia.
You know, this is our famous actor, our famous stepson, and various other personalities involved. So, you will all get a copy of the report now.
We decided to do a little bit more in-depth research right after the DOJ in the US, the Department of Justice, when they filed a civil suit to claim back the stolen assets. The assets that were bought with stolen money in New York, in California, and the list went on. It wasn't just about condos and luxury houses. It was about private jets. It was about yachts, hotels, and everything is based on our money. And it also went further into funding The Wolf on Wall Street. I'm sure many of us saw that. I mean, it was an Academy Award nominee for Best Picture, Best Actor, and so on. So we contributed a lot in terms of that. Now, globally, there is a lot of movement about claiming back stolen assets by anti-corruption groups, international financial institutions, all looking at how can you actually claim back the stolen money? And probably more realistic stolen property, buildings and so on and so forth. So it needs to come back to Malaysia because our institutions have closed off a lot of their doors on investigating something that is unresolved. It is not yet resolved. So the research, we want to launch it today. We're happy to launch it before media, before one or two diplomatic representatives that are here and Malaysians from different spectrums. To actually talk to you about two parts. One was, the first part was written by Mr. P. Gunasegram. He is a business writer, business editor. So that one was very much part of the details of the DOJ filing. And since then, the Singapore courts, the Swiss AG has also taken action. The second part, the writer is not here today. She's Dato' Latifah American Chong, former Bank Negara Assistant Governor, and also done consultancy with the World Bank. Her part in the report, which you will get right after the launch, is actually to look at the regulations. Were there enough regulations? Were there enough standards internationally to actually stop financial flows of this nature? Or were there not enough? Or were there enough, but they just couldn't stop someone like MO1 from doing whatever he liked? Now, what really was the problem? So I think we actually want to deliberate on these things further and to look at what are next steps that we can take. And the next steps are really important because, as I said, it's far from resolved. And we also know that this year is probably going to be a general elections year. So it's all going to be heightened. And just yesterday in Parliament, we were told that the debts of 1 MBP were paid off. Now, if you follow, okay, you all are already laughing. So I don't need to go into the details that if we know there's still a 40 billion debt ringgit that has not been sorted out.